knew I always wanted to be a nurse since I was a little kid and just never thought I could do it. And during the birth of my first daughter, I got very, very ill. And I delivered here at UHC 8 weeks early. And I spent about 4 days in ICU. And the care I got at UHC was amazing. And I knew it was my second chance at life. And I knew that I was supposed to pursue what I wanted to do. So I just always wanted to be the nurse that I had. Take care of me, I wanted to be that nurse for other people. I think once a nurse, you're always a nurse, no matter what, especially if you're a parent. You can halfway shut your brain off and focus on being a mom and a wife and things you need to do, but there's always what you need to do next or whose surgery's next week and what you need to do for them to make sure everything goes okay. We have a lot of Fairmont State students that come here, a lot of the athletes, they're injured. We have to give them care. So they're away from home. They don't have their family here. You know, they're nervous, they're scared. So you kind of become that mother for them while they're here in the office. So you have to comfort them and reassure them that everything's going to be okay. All the players have my phone number to the office in case they have questions or need anything. So you kind of step in that role of a caregiver for those athletes that are away from home. So you just try to reassure them and let them know you're there to support them and let them know you're their biggest fan. I think hope is huge. You have to give them hope that at the end of the surgery, everything's going to be different because they're coming in here. You know, they haven't been able to walk properly in a couple years. They're in excruciating pain, even just trying to stand up out of a chair. So you always have to give them the reassurance that, you know, you've been through this with other patients, at family members that have had surgery through UHC with joint replacements, and they've done amazing. So I always have their stories to say. You know, my grandmother can get down on the floor and play with her great-grandchildren, and she would never have been able to do that without having her knee replaced. I think that our surgery department is amazing. I've had the opportunity not only through school, but just as an employee to watch several surgeries, watch different surgeons and see how they do things in the OR. And I'm always amazed every time, and I always learn something about the procedures and how they take care of their patients. If someone's trying to figure out which facility to have surgery at, you do have to do your research. You have to find out who's going to work best for you. Call their staff members. I always encourage people, you know, if you have questions, call me. You might not be a patient here, but I'll answer whatever questions you have regarding surgery or anything like that. So call other surgeons if you want. Talk to their staff. You'll get a good feel for how that doctor is by how that staff member reacts to you. Hopefully my patients remember me as having patience with them and being able to help them with whatever they need. Might take me a day to get back with them when they make phone calls, but they always know that I'll be there for them no matter what. I'm just a phone call away.